But I must say I was shocked when I heard that Kamala was skipping the Al Smith dinner. I'd really hoped that she would come because we can't get enough of hearing her beautiful laugh. She laughs like crazy. We would recognize it any place in this room, and all polls are indicating I'm leading big with the Catholic vote, as I should be, as I should be. But I don't think Kamala has given up yet. She hasn't. Instead of attending tonight, she's in Michigan receiving communion from Gretchen Whitmer.
Yo, you should never underestimate a person as willing to tell jokes about themselves and other people. And Trump was at this dinner absolutely roasting both Kamala Harris and Joe Biden while at the same time roasting everybody else that's around him. And let me just say something about Gretchen Whitmer. For some reason, somehow, and this is how I know that it's not based off of identity politics, or maybe it is, who knows? Gretchen Whitmer in Michigan somehow has endeared herself to Michiganders. Now, there's a lot of people that don't like her, and then there's a lot of people that really love her. So she's kind of polarizing in a way because she kind of brands herself in the same way that Trump does, but on the opposite side when it comes to creating visibility for herself. And she's really, really aligned herself with Kamala Harris and Joe Biden and all of that stuff. But I am not a huge fan of Gretchen Whitmer. I try to stay away from it. And for those of y'all that's not familiar, that's actually the Michigan governor. I try to stay away from Michigan and Detroit politics because I also understand that, is it a possibility that that could affect me also? Personally, I don't know. So, you know, you got to kind of take it with a grain of sand. But I've been openly vocal about not necessarily caring about, you know, the way that she aligns herself with Oprah, and they, you know, they kind of got her next up. They also had Jennifer Granholm, who was a former governor of Michigan during the time where Michigan and Detroit was hemorrhaging jobs and they were doing really, really bad. And she was the governor, and she's sitting right next to Biden as one of his top aides. So, you know, I'm sure that she always will have a job and always will have a great place in the cabinet of whatever Democrat is popping at the time, or whatever Democrat is, you know, the loudest at the time. But let's get back to this whole Trump conversation and this Trump roast.
That's not a pretty sight. But Catholics, please don't be too insulted by Kamala's absence. If the Democrats, he says, thank you very much, I appreciate it. If Democrats really wanted to have someone not be with us this evening, they would have just sent Joe Biden. You know, he's having second thoughts, you know that, right? He wants to come back. If she does any worse in the polls, they're going to bring him back again, I think. Chuck, he's going to do it. He's the one that got him out. That's the guy. Much more so than Crazy Nancy, I will tell you, because I know him. He did it. Joe has almost disappeared from view. The only way he could be seen less is if he had a show on CNN. They had nothing. They've got nothing. Fake news, right? Fake. That term wasn't good. You know, they say the term is no longer in vogue because it's much worse than fake. I don't want to tell you what the real name is. I won't do it, because all those cameras would shut off immediately. They don't like that. But apparently Joe didn't think it was fair for me to have the podium to myself with Kamala skipping the event. So he called, looked at me, and said, don't. Does anybody understand that? Yes. I thought it was actually very good until just now. It was announced this morning that at a funeral yesterday, in a rare moment of clarity, Joe told Barack Hussein Obama that, quote, only a few people got that. Or as Rush Limbaugh used to say, Barack Hussein Obama. Remember, bro? He was a piece of work. We miss him. But as he told Barack Hussein Obama, quote, she's not as strong as me. She's not as strong. Do you understand that? And Obama agreed, saying, that's true. Other than that, I think the Democrats are getting along quite well, right? Again, nobody got that one. The fact is, we need new leadership in this country. Right now, we have someone in the White House who can barely talk, barely put together two coherent sentences, who seems to have mental faculties of a child, it's sad. There's a person that has nothing going, no intelligence whatsoever, but enough about Kamala Harris. Let's get on to something.
Jesus Christ. Yeah, I think that it's going to be a wash, honestly, especially after that Fox News interview. Did y'all see the video of the lip readers that was basically trying to break down Joe Biden and Kamala Harris's, I'm sorry, Joe Biden and Barack Obama's lip reading? I've seen a couple different videos of that on social media. And so that's what he was referring to as far as saying that she's not as strong as him and stuff like that. But I truly do believe that Joe Biden felt like he was the best person for the job and that he's the person that should still be in this race, which to some people will say that that just shows you the delusion of the Democrats and of Joe Biden himself. And one of the main reasons why he shouldn't be in a race in the first place. But then, you know, he got pushed out by other Democrats, not because they didn't only feel like he couldn't win, especially after the debate, but also because they felt like they were going to be affected down ballot, because a lot of people, when they go to vote at the polls, they're not as informed. And so usually they just select Democrat Party or Republican Party or Green Party or whatever party, but mostly Democrat and Republican Party. And then they just vote down ballot, that whole thing. They don't research their judges. They don't research who's in Congress. They don't research who's also affected from those other legislative branches. So a lot of people are hinging their hopes and their successes on Trump or the Democratic Party winning and now Kamala Harris. And so people are speculating that Joe Biden was basically saying that Kamala Harris is not as strong, and that Obama was basically saying, well, you know, she got time. We're going to get her together and we're going to figure it out. But that would also lead you to believe that either A, they feel like she's going to win this election, or they're going to try to get her to win this election, or B, they're prepping her for the possibility of running again in 2028, which I do believe that you'll see another Kamala Harris run in 2028, which then throws into question who else would run against her. And do she automatically get the nod for the Democratic Party if she decides that she wants to run again in 2028? But I'm curious as to what y'all think. Make sure y'all tap into the Patreon. Link is in the description. Also, Teach Hanley, 40% off your first order plus 20% off of life. And then also get your tickets to come and kick it with me in person. All of that is in the description. Atlanta, Detroit, so far. Put discount code Anton in there and then let's have some fun. Yeah, y'all let me know what y'all think. Do you think that Kamala Harris is going to win or run in 2028? And do you agree with the lip readers from Barack Obama and Biden? And do you also believe that Trump is just absolutely destroying her and he's going to win in a landslide? Let me know in the comments. I love you. I appreciate you. I'm going to holler at y'all later. Peace.